Hello, welcome to this draw with me, which wasn't exactly planned like this. I'm talking today. This is rather unusual for this format of mine, but anyways, I started a new series of paintings, yay! I set my mind on illustrating the 8 Witches Sabbaths in an Art Nouveau style, and this is the one I'm starting with, Beltane. Actually, I wanted the videos to be magical and cinematic, but during the process of painting, so many things went wrong that I couldn't post it with a clear conscience without telling you how chaotic this was. So, I did my research first, but I couldn't find a reference picture of the pose I had in mind, so I made my own. Then I realized that I still suck at getting anatomy and proportions right and that I was pressed for time, so I traced the outlines of my body in Krita. Yeah, this sometimes happens when I draw on my tablet. Let's delete and... Okay, yeah. As I said, I traced it, removed the background and had a posing dummy image. And here you can see that I did the screencast after I already finished my dummy. But yeah. After I printed myself in the size I wanted my finished painting to be, I sat down and sketched directly on the dummy. So now the fun stuff starts! Little did I know. To transfer my sketch onto my watercolor paper, I traced it with sandwich paper first. So far so good. But then I made the first major mistake. I took carbon paper to trace the already traced drawing. If you know how carbon paper works, you also know that it can get a bit messy. But I wasn't thinking about that and started even coloring in the copy I made with it. Soon, an unwanted, even almost denied realization came to me. These outlines were impossible to cover up with the colors I had planned for this painting, and at some places the carbon paper had smudged and left really ugly stains. Really frustrated at this point, I took a break and tried to think of another way to transfer the sketch, when I had an epiphany. I need a light box. Good that my birthday is coming up soon. But until then, I taped the sandwich paper drawing and my watercolor paper to my window and traced it with a light pink colored pencil. Finally, after 3 hours of tracing the same image over and over again and watching several episodes of Tiger King, I could start coloring it and also tell you something about Beltane. I'm not a Wiccan or pagan or any member of religion who celebrates the Sabbats, but I consider myself an art witch and I'm really interested in all kinds of practices and traditions. Most of the information I used to come up with this concept I got from Harmony Nice's video on the topic, which I linked in the description box for you. First, I extracted 3 main keywords for the Sabbat, which are sexuality, passion and thriving. Then I wrote down anything that could be visualized in a painting, such as relevant crystals, colors, food, flowers, etc. I took a look at some Beltane practices and found the dancing round the maypole as the best one to realize in an Art Nouveau style. By using this tradition, I could incorporate spring flowers and ribbons in the relevant colors. The pole itself is a symbol for sexuality, and the dancing woman perfectly illustrates the passion which rises during this time of the year. When you look up Art Nouveau paintings, the characters are often surrounded by plants, geometrical elements, or even have prompts to sit on or hold in their hands. Since oats is an important grain, I put it in one corner of the frame. To balance this out, I decided on Lilies of the Valley for the other side. The 3 moon elements at the woman's feet represent the triple goddess. I don't really know this deity, but I like the symbol and found that it fits perfectly for the theme. For the font, I searched Art Nouveau on dafont.com, downloaded and printed it and glued it to the sketch, so that I could save some time. I do this in my bullet journal all the time, because I'm not a graphic designer and I don't enjoy hand lettering so much, and I think it's okay to cheat a little on this part. The frame I drew freehandedly to give it a final Art Nouveau look. During coloring, I struggled with the color palette. I'm still not totally confident with watercolors, and often the shades don't turn out like I wanted them to. I found it too bright. During the process, I even compared it to a kindergarten coloring book, which isn't my style at all. But looking at my references, which you can find on my Pinterest board called Beltane, by the way, I couldn't figure out what I was doing wrong. The paintings I looked at had bright colors too, but seemed to be muted in some form that I couldn't capture. I ended up muting the colors layer by layer until I was kind of content with them, and then I outlined everything besides the flowers with a thick dark brown line. Despite all the errors and frustration, I'm rather happy with the result. Considering that I have to improve a lot on drawing humans, I think that I did a good job in coming up with the idea and the final concept. Does it look like Art Nouveau in the context of 1920s art? No. But in the context of 2020, I'm still finding my own style. Please don't judge I did this for the first time. I think it has some similarities. And overall, this is the first one of 8, and who knows how much I improve until Ostara next year. I hope you liked this video and me rambling about the process. Make sure to subscribe if you haven't already, and also hop over to Instagram where I post my art and journal stuff and some personal stuff regularly, and leave a like on this one. I would really, really appreciate it. And until next week, bye. Alles gut, ich nehme Voiceover auf. Alles gut, ich nehme Voiceover auf.